Roy Woods, baby. Let's go, man. So, as you guys may not know, we got the OVO gear on. We weren't even geared for Roy Woods. We just recorded a future review. Go check that out if you guys have not already, for his Project High Off Life. Check our old reviews if you haven't. I'm Irish if you don't know.
Yeah, I'm first.
Crazy statistic. We got 98% of you guys who are watching this have not subscribed. And that's crazy right now. So
it is crucial that y'all subscribe, y'all like, comment, share it with your friends.
Because we are the first people to review every single project. Thanks, we're up there. And we try to give our most diligent reviews as quick as we can. So we are, you know, we got We're Canadian, we're from Windsor. Comment below where you guys are from, where y'all you started crazy, listening to Roy.
Y'all got that crazy sleep schedules, you know. Y'all don't got anything else to do, you know.
And if you took a listen to this Roy Woods project and you're watching this review right now, comment below what you thought of it, what your favorite tracks were. We have not listened to it yet. That's why we're making this intro. And I'm really excited to listen to this EP, this project. It's been a while since we got some Roy Woods shit, and I mean, I can't take another second to wait and not listen to it. So we're going to jump right into it. This is a 6-track EP from Roy. If we're going to talk about his best project, I still think Waking at Dawn is his best. And then X's and then Nocturnal. But everything is very, very solid. Some of his unreleased tracks that are really good are Skirt and...
Skirt is one of my all-time
Skirt, favorite. The Skirt remix. Tracks, I think he did it better than Kodak. Great. But, I mean... Why is up there with one of his best songs, if not his best. Drama, I Get still, You Good, Jealousy was one of my favorite tracks.
I still feel like Waking at Dawn was his best works to this day. Yeah. But let us know down below what you think Roy Wood's best album is. Hopefully, if you guys haven't heard of Roy Woods before, this video introduces you to him.
Roy Woods is
criminally underrated.
From the Greater Toronto area. Hopefully, this album charts decently high, especially in quarantine. Perfect time to release this for Roy. Get him some recognition because there's not as much music flowing as we initially thought. So here we go. Dem Times, Roy Woods. I'm looking forward to, as Raptors fans, we're looking forward to the track Lake Pascal. But... we've already heard I Feel It, but we're still gonna listen to it again. So let's get into it. Oh, jeez. Roy Woods, Dem Times. Let's get it. All right, so this is track one, To Me. If we get the Roy X's, because, like, we had on Say Less, we had, you know, like, hype tracks, like, Baby and Undivided, or not Undivided was the closest we got to X's, but if we have like tracks like Baby and Top Left and stuff that were very, you know, like upbeat, like Say Less wasn't the direction I wanted Roy, and I know it was the direct, like it wasn't similar to X's or Waking at Dawn or stuff we were like. Nocturnal was kind of the evolution of him, but like this EP, if we get the, it's right now it sounded like it's gonna be a little X's with I Feel It and the way this is starting, so I'm excited right now. Is, but you still want more. Facts. Yeah. Summertime, you run it out. Me trying to fall in love. Since you trying to stack it up. Summertime, you run it out. Summertime, you fuck it up. Okay, so that was track one,
that's
To
a,
Me.
That was a really,
and like,
really
the
strong opening.
Bro, like, the reason crazy. I got a smile on my face is because I think that was his best opening track ever. Like, I swear to God, I think it was his best opening track ever. I think it was better than Magic. I think it was better than,
Sonic Boom is like, Sonic Boom's really, also good, I don't even know if you can just make that, like,
it's the best, it's the best opening track I've ever heard from him. That shit was amazing. That shit was unbelievable. The way he switched melodies, cadences, flows, the way he started rapping, that I've never heard that from Roy that hard. That shit was crazy. I loved it. So we got track two, Never Your Way. Bro, this is some more, like, reflective Roy, but also, like, the Roy, like, the R&B we wanted. And this is, like, after all this time, he's coming back to give us summer sad vibes. It's crazy, man. These are the vibes that we needed from Roy.
I feel like he always comes around during summer, too. It's crazy.
All right, Roy's 2 for 2. That was very, very catchy. That could be I mean, that wasn't even the single, but that was a great, great follow-up
track. It could be a single from this album. For real. You know, I don't know. He's bringing the... It's like... Yeah. I don't know. I feel like it's an evolution of the X's vibes. I don't feel like he's bringing us just the X's vibes. I feel like he's exceeding the X's vibes and bringing us, you know, more than what we asked for, which is always... That's always good, so...
Because I remember Sayless released... My freshman year. So this is it's been almost 3 years since Say Less, and I'm very, very happy that we finally got a Roy project, and this shit is bangers, man. So we got track 3, Cool J. Yeah. He switched up the whole... Bro, this is the best I've ever heard from Roy. I swear to God, bro. So that was track 3. Cool J. Every song like on here... I mean, that has to be my second favorite behind 2ME.
Yeah.
2ME was just intro vibes.
That might have... honestly might have been my favorite on here so far. Just because it kind of brought the summer vibes together, you know? I was listening to that song and the thought just popped in my head. I was like, this shit would hit different if we actually got to go outside, you know? Because, you know, as like we live in Michigan, it's one of the only states that hasn't opened back up yet. Which, I mean, you do what you gotta do, I guess. Do what you gotta do to keep everyone safe. But, you know, could really use some outside right now. But hopefully this virus goes away soon. Hopefully y'all are staying safe. Stay healthy as much as you can. Stay safe. Obviously, don't go outside if you're not supposed to, you know, all that shit. But we got
track four.
Yeah, like Pascal. Track 4, like Pascal.
Here we go, Raptors champion still.
That sounds excited.
Wow, that sounds so sick.
Imagine them playing this at the
Imagine them playing this in the Raptors arena. Damn, bro, that'd be... we'll have to see right now. I know they're gonna play it
after every shot. They just play it like
this. I know they're gonna play it.
The hook of this song.
Okay, so like being from Toronto, like no matter how much like Future just came out, Young Thug just came out, and like no matter what, the real Toronto people are always going to, you know, appreciate the vibes, music more than... That's why we so are inclined to The Weeknd and Drake made more life, because
Logic, Jordan,
we're so inclined, you know, like we don't really have futures where we come from, and even the Toronto rap is so melodic, but you know, that we're more inclined to that and like Ram Riddles than we are Future and Young Thug, but like it appeals to us more, but we like gravitate towards that as well. We gravitate towards this, but like it's hard to explain, but you guys, I hope you guys know what I mean. That's fire, bro.
I feel like as this project is going on and on, I just keep finding more favorites, more highlights, more better moments of this EP, which is crazy. That's very unique in any project.
This is all going on my playlist. What I find out that's really weird is like he added I Feel It, which is the last track. That was the single. So we're on track 5, What We Did. Oh, this is about to be another feel one. I swear to God,
bro. The last
new track. Bro, this is about to be a feel track. It's about to be them times. Oh my God. If this is what I think it is, this is about to be Roy's best project. I swear to God. This is like different Roy music, but this is the best shit I've ever heard from him, like by far. Like, this is wild. Them times. So I'm scrolling through Twitter right now, And I see a lot of people not feeling this project, which is crazy because
I really enjoyed that album or that EP.
Bro, that was the most emotional Roy Woods shit I have ever heard in my life. That was the most enjoyable for me, and I don't give a fuck what anybody else thinks. I really, really, really do not give a fuck what they think, because I already know what I'm going to rate this project, and that's not changing. But what is changing is the ratings of some of my other projects after this one dropped. So that's all I'm gonna say. You guys saw it from my reaction.
Personally, I think, like, when you look at his other projects, I don't think that anything has topped Waking at Dawn yet. That's just my personal preference. But this yes. project,
the fuck are you talking about?
This project had a shit ton of emotion, like, packed into every single song, back to back to back to back. Even though it was only like six songs, those six songs carried more emotion than some artists' entire albums do today, which is like that's saying something. You know, Roy always comes with a quality over quantity, so it's better that we get six songs of pure emotion, you know, just pure R&B, than like get like 20 songs of some filler shit, you know. But I like the production, all the emotion on these songs. So I think, even though this is an EP, I think I'm gonna have to change the ratings a bit because it's an EP, not an album. But I think I'm gonna give it a. I think honestly, I'm gonna give it a 7.5 out of 10.
So, I don't understand. Like, there's not one song I didn't like. So I'm just thinking like. Like, obviously, 10 is, like, a perfect EP. I'd give My Dear Melancholy, like, a... for like, we're putting EPs in, like, that shit on a different scale. So, My Dear... like, we already gave Kelly, which is, like, a 7, like, which I... Yeah. So, I think that, like, basically, like, if we give Kelly, which is a 7, I think that... And, I didn't this was different than anything Roy dropped, you know, like, anything, any like, different thing that Roy dropped, ever, and I think it's more advanced than it, and I don't know why so many people are saying it's garbage, but this shit fire, like, this shit is absolutely fire, so I'm gonna go ahead and rate it 8.5, like, that's straight.
I still definitely feel like, I still stand by what I said, and the fact that this album, or EP, had more emotion packed into it than a lot of artists are putting into their music today, which is really that's what's gonna give this EP longevity in the future. It's just that, like, when you go back to it, I feel like it's gonna be one of those projects that just hits harder and harder every time, and it just grows like fine wine with age, you know.
Everyone keeps saying that this EP is not his old shit, and I'm sick and tired of these guys like saying that shit, because
yeah.
Everyone is saying that, you know, old music is not like new music. And, like, for every artist, they say that shit. And I guess it's just the nostalgic feel of it and how, you know, you're so used to what that artist, like, used to put out or what got you into that artist. And they don't give a fuck about it. So, like, and I don't give a fuck if you give a fuck about it, because it's just dumb. You know, like, people, Travis fans say Rodeo's better. And generally, like, everyone's inclined to believe that. But artists are so prone to, like, saying, like, Drake's. If you think about it, like, Drake's old music's better. Ye's music's old music is better. If they choose to put something out, then you should just let that be. You know, like, you can make your own judgment on it. And you can say if it's, like, lackluster and whatnot. But for now, just so let the project soak in for a couple weeks, and then you can give your opinion on it. People just will, like Drake said, people want to be the first to just comment whether or not it's trash. And in general, I just want you guys to know, have a general consensus, which is why I want to give a rating. But I don't even like giving ratings off of first listen, because you need to let the music soak in after people work so damn hard on a project, you know.
I feel like people need to accept that it's an evolution of the artist's sound, rather than continuously begging and pleading for the artist to go back to their old sound. Like, I always say, people say, oh, After Hours didn't sound like the Trilogy, Kissland Weekend. Yeah, you're damn right, it didn't sound like the Trilogy, Kissland Weekend, because it's a more mature form of that artist. You know, all the artists, most artists' music is like their lyrics and their content and their music is like what they've been through, their life experiences. Obviously, as you live life, you experience more things, you know, you change, meet new people. So with that, your sound, if you're an artist, your sound is not going to stay the same. It's going to change over time. It's going to evolve over time as you evolve and age over time and become more mature as a person and an artist. So for all you guys saying, oh, I want the old this and this back, just be happy with what we got for now. The old albums are there. If you want to go listen to them, feel free to go listen to them, you know. But artists aren't going to just change back their whole sound back to what it was just for you, you know.
So that was our Roy Woods review. Thank you guys for watching that. If you guys haven't already, hit that sub button for us. I'm Irish.
Furs.
Take care, you guys. Peace.